Hello friends, recently in my YouTube channel I have published a video to show you how you can use the file upload components inside your Salesforce flow and then also display the uploaded file names on the same screen. And here is the video. So in that video, I got a comment from one of my subscribers called Masood that how I can make that file upload mandatory. By mandatory means someone will not be able to move to the next screen without uploading any file using the file upload component on that flow screen. So let's build that and let's do that in our Salesforce flow. So here I am in my Salesforce org. So let's go to the flow and see this in action. If I go to the flow and let's create our screen flow and let's put a screen element. Give it a name as test. Here, let's bring the file upload component. Give it a name as file upload. And upload your files, multiple files. Let's make it true. And so far, so it looks good. Let's put one more here. Just text, display text. This will basically show the uploaded file names. And I've already shown you a detailed video how you can configure that. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put the link in the description as well as on the top right corner. You can go and check that out. But this is where I'm going a little bit first because the intention is not to show this one, but how to make this field mandatory. So uploaded file names. And here I can choose file upload, call file names, and then it will show that. Now, as you can see here, there is no way I can make that field mandatory. It's not possible. So let's click on turn and let's put one more screen element. Make it test two. And for the time being, let's put our display text here. Message, and let's put a display text as screen 2. Done. Let's save at file upload mandatory and click on save and activate. And now if I go and debug this flow, as you can see that it's telling me to upload a file. And since I've not uploaded anything, so uploaded file name is blank. And if I click on next, it's taking me to the next screen. But what I want, if there is no uploaded file, when I click on next, it should not take me to the next screen. Rather, it should show me an error message that you forgot to upload files. So you can only proceed when you upload something, right? Basically, make this upload a mandatory in your business process. So how you can do that? So for that, what you can do, let's go back to this screen again. And here, this is upload files. Here, if you drag to the bottom, you see there is an option called validate input. So here you will find two options. One is called error message and another is called formula, as you can see in the screen. So formula is a place where you will write your own logic to validate whether there is something being uploaded or not. And if that formula comes as negative, it means there is nothing being uploaded. That's the time when you put your custom error message, and that error message you can write on this error message section. So let's start with the formula. Here is the formula which I'm going to use. File upload is basically the API name of this file upload component I've given here. And this component comes with some variables where you store the variable name, where you store the uploaded files property. One of the things is like content doc IDs. What I am checking here, if the length of the content doc IDs is greater than 2, then return me true, otherwise return me false. Now, why 2? The content doc ID is basically, by default, if you do not upload anything, if there is nothing uploaded, then content doc ID always looks like this. So length is always by default 2. When you uploaded something, that record's 18-digit ID will come here. So you've uploaded 2 records, then 2 18-digit IDs will come here like this and then this. Just think this is an 18-digit ID. So all I'm doing is that if the content top ID's length is greater than 2, it means I have uploaded something. My user has uploaded something. If it is not greater than 2, means there's nothing being uploaded. That's what I want to check. So in that case, I can put an error message like, you need to upload something before you can proceed to the next screen. Right? And I can make this red and bold. So, all I'm doing, checking the content of ID, if the length is greater than 2, then fine. If it is less, if it's not greater than 2, then I'm throwing the error message. So, just click on done, save as, and activate. And now let's do the debug. Now, this time, again, I've not uploaded anything. But if I click on next, I'm not being allowed to go to the next screen. All I'm getting is an error message that telling I need to upload something before I can proceed to the next screen. So let's say I upload a file, and the moment my upload is done, now I can go to the next screen. Easy. So that's a way how we can make your file upload component mandatory within your ScreenFlow. So I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon, share this video with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.